From News 8 WMTW-TV, this is a News 8 Now update.
You're watching News 8 Now. I'm Shannon Moss.
And I'm Erin O'Valley. Kennebunk police have released the names of, so far, 21 men summoned on charges of engaging a prostitute.
An attorney for two of the clients on that list tried three times to get a judge to block the list's release, but a judge denied that request yesterday afternoon. Attorney Stephen Schwartz, who represents two of the men, said it was an invasion of privacy and would cause irreparable harm to the men's families and personal lives. Court disagreed and denied the request, but agreed that addresses should be withheld. Schwartz believes those on the list will still be found. After the names were released yesterday, Schwartz told News 8, quote, the victim's rights statute specifically says he can't release addresses or information from which addresses may be gleaned. The mere releasing of names could lead to the accused and create confusion in the community. Former Zumba instructor Alexis Wright and Thomaston businessman Mark Strong have both pleaded not guilty in connection with this case. They're accused of using the Pura Vida Zumba studio as a front for a prostitution business. Well, the Maine Department of Transportation will be closing Sewell's Bridge in York for the next year starting today. The bridge crosses the York River. Maine DOT says the new bridge will replicate the features of the existing bridge by using composite materials at a cost of nearly $3.4 million. A four-mile detour will be set up around the bridge.
Some traffic lanes on the Sarah Long Bridge between Portsmouth and New Hampshire and Kittery will be closed for the next few days while the bridge is inspected. The work started yesterday morning and could last up to 6 days. The lane closures will be from 7:30 in the morning until 4 o'clock in the afternoon. Of course, drivers are being asked to use alternate routes if possible to avoid those delays. And thanks for tuning in to this News 8 Now update. I'm Erin O'Valley.
And I'm Shannon Moss. Make sure to check out our other top stories of the day on our website, WMTW.com. Have a great day, everyone.